Yes, students. Now, next we'll discuss a numerical based on law of conservation of mass. Again, I repeat, this law of conservation of mass in your theory part for this session 2021, it is not there, but it is included in your practical. So that experiment you have to write in your practical record to verify law of conservation of mass. But you should have a basic knowledge of this particular topic. So I am explaining here. I am taking one numerical as well. Okay. So in a reaction, 4.2 gram sodium carbonate. Sodium carbonate. How much? 4.2 gram. Reacted with 10 gram ethanoic acid. Ethanoic acid, how much? 10 gram. The products were 2.2 gram carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide, how much? 2.2 gram. And 12 gram sodium ethanoate. Sodium ethanoate, how much? 12 gram. So these two are the reactants, sodium carbonate, ethanoic acid, and these are the products, carbon dioxide and sodium ethanoate. Now your question is, show that these observations are in agreement with law of conservation of mass. So what I discussed just now, what is law of conservation of mass? In any chemical reaction, total mass of reactant is equal to total mass of product. That you have to prove by these datas given. Okay. So 10 plus 4.2, how much? 14.2 gram. So this is the total mass of reactant. Then 12 plus 2.2, how much? 14.2 gram. This is the mass of the product. So what do you observe in this reaction? Total mass of reactant is equal to total mass of product. Okay. Now, steps if you write, you will write total mass of reactant is equal to, what is the reactant? Sodium carbonate, ethanoic acid. Mass of sodium carbonate plus mass of ethanoic acid. How much? Sodium carbonate 4.2. plus ethanoic acid 10 gram. So how much? 14.2 gram. This is mass of reactant. Next, total mass of product. And what are the products? Carbon dioxide and sodium ethanoate. So mass of carbon dioxide plus mass of sodium ethanoate. How much? 2.2 gram. 2.2 gram plus 12 gram. How much? 14.2 gram. So this is the mass of the product. So total mass of reactant is equal to total mass of product. So, it proves law of conservation of mass. Okay. So, students, today we discussed one of the law of chemical combination, that is law of conservation of mass. Okay. So, this is not in your theory part. It is included in the practical. So this is your experiment number 4 to verify law of conservation of mass. So you'll write the experiment in your practical record. Okay. And the statements about law of conservation of mass, one example and one numerical you write in your notebook, but it is not in there in your theory part for this year. Okay. And next period, next class, we'll discuss the second law of chemical combination, that is law of constant proportion. Okay.